Well, welcome back to my channel. So far we have seen different types of classifier evaluation methods in machine learning. That is, we saw the holdout method, we saw the random subsampling, and then we have something called as cross validation and nested cross validation in order to overcome the limitation which was there by the random subsampling. So before that, I thought the need of explaining a concept called as the hyperparameter. Why? Because this term or this concept is mainly used in cross validation as well as nested cross validation. So in today's video, let's see what is hyperparameter. So let's begin. So basically, before starting with the hyperparameter, let us consider the term that is parameter. Now, since we are learning about the machine, we have created a model. So the model you get from your training data, and then you evaluate its performance based upon the test data. So here what you have is basically in machine learning, that is the model parameter which is there, that is an intrinsic configuration to the model and whose value is defined by the data. Now what this basically means is, say you have a model. Now this could be naive bias, and say for example it has three parameters, p1, p2, p3, and what it does is it does the predictions. So predictions could be prediction 1, prediction 2, prediction 3, or you have prediction n. So it creates n number of predictions based upon the values it gets. So in terms of statistics, we have say mu and sigma parameter. So mu is the mean and sigma is a standard deviation. So if we want to derive these parameters, we derive from the data that we have. So we have some data points or a stream of data x1, x2, x3, and based upon that you derive this. And if you want to estimate the normal distribution, then we use this parameter, that is in this formula e raised to x minus mu the whole square upon 2 sigma. So with this you just put the value of mu and sigma into this, and then you estimate the function for this. In terms of programming, you have a concept called as parameterized method. So say for example you have a method foo, and it has got a parameter that is int a, means it takes all the integer values. So it can take any values up till n, and it has further lines of code defined by the programmer. Now this is the basics of the model parameter which you already know. Now in machine learning, where these concepts are used, so in artificial neural networks we have something called as weights which are associated with this model. So these weights are nothing but the model parameter. In support vector machine, you have the support vectors which are model parameter. Or in regression, specifically when you deal with that is logistic and linear regression, you have some coefficients. So these coefficients are nothing but the model parameter. Now this was all regarding the model parameter. Now let's deal with the term hyperparameter. So it has got one prefix before the term parameter. So let's go with the definition. So it's a configuration that is external to the model and whose value cannot be estimated from the data. Means whatever you give the hyperparameter, so consider say this is a model and you just provide this externally. Now hyperparameter has got three things to deal with. So first, it is set by a practitioner. So practitioner could be your data analyst. Second is hyperparameter is used to derive the model parameters. Means before the model parameters are derived, you set the hyperparameter externally. And third is hyperparameter is derived from heuristics. Means there is a self discovery of the value instead of it's being automatically set. Now these are the three things which are associated with the hyperparameter. Now where in machine learning hyperparameter is used? say we have already seen the KNN model. So that is the k nearest neighbors, and we define the value of k, that is k is equal to 3, 5, 7. That determines the number of nearest neighbors which it has. Or if you have the clustering algorithm, say k means and k medoids, you have this parameter, that is you need to define the number of clusters which you want to have. That is, if you want to have 3 clusters or 5 clusters, you need to determine it predefined. So this thing which you determine previously before studying your algorithm, that this is nothing but the hyperparameter. Or in support vector machine, we have some terms or some parameters like c and sigma. So these are nothing but the hyperparameter which you set externally. Now, how to differentiate between a model parameter and a hyperparameter? So if you have a model parameter and it is manually set, then if this parameter is manually set, then this is probably a hyperparameter. So if you don't manually set it, then that becomes a model parameter. But instead, if you set manually, then that becomes a hyperparameter. So well, that was all regarding the hyperparameter concept in machine learning. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. And as you were watching this video, please do like, share, comment. And if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.